Let's get salty!
Everyone, Zeddy here again today with a brand new video, and I have done it. I have completed every single Forge in the Barrens achievement, so I'm ready to give you my achievement guide on how to unlock all 16,000 experience points from the achievements, as well as the nearly 1,200 achievement points that mean nothing, but they're kind of cool to have. So before we get into the specific achievements, I want to give some general tips and outlines of how to complete the achievements and all stuff you need to know. So first off, XP on these will only be given during this expansion period. So once the next expansion comes out this summer, you cannot earn the XP on these anymore. Just like we saw the Darkmoon Fair XP go away when the Barrens came out, the same thing will happen this summer. You also can't save the XP on an achievement for the next rewards track. They only count for this one. As well as all achievements can be completed on either ladder, arena, or duels. And duels, it can be either the free mode or the heroic mode where you have to pay gold or use a tavern ticket or whatever. It cannot be completed in casual, friendly matches, or tavern brawl. They do not count there at all. I don't know why. It's annoying, but it can. But one tip, one thing, if you are missing a key legendary or epic, you can try and use arena or duels. Draft them there because you don't have to actually own them to draft them there. You can get it there and it will count. So do like a free duels run over and over until you draft the card you're looking for, and that can help you complete some of these achievements in that regard. This video, all the mentioned decks and descriptions, experience points, achievement point breakdowns can be found on this Google document. The link can be found in the description below. I spent a lot of time on this trying to make it nice and organized for all of you, so you can go in there because it wouldn't fit all in the description. I spent a lot of time in it, so I'd really appreciate it if you could drop a like or a sub on the video just to, you know, make it more than worth it. I would really appreciate it. So let's get going. Let's take a look at every single achievement from Forge in the Barrens, class by class, and then neutrals. There should be timestamps if you want to skip ahead to a specific achievement. And one thing I want to note with these decks, most of them are wild-based. I did most of them in wild, so you can try and substitute stuff for standard or not, but I did it wild-based. It's a lot easier to do a lot of these achievements, and I'll try and give some tips on standard if I can, but overall, these are mostly wild-centric. So first, we have to the left, most to the wall. It's destroy 30 minions with Kurtris Outfall, and this is for Demon Hunter, and I just used a Death Rattle Demon Hunter deck. It has like Illidari Studies. You can get Kurtris back over and over with Illidari. Play it itself. It's in the deck. You'll eventually get this one done. It's a progression one, but this deck list worked pretty well for me. As was did for this one, don't dead open inside to summon 50 Death Rattle minions without playing them as Demon Hunter. Same thing, just cheat out Death Rattles with this deck. Works pretty well. Again, progressive. It'll take some time, but you'll get there. And then we have a really annoying one that I recommend waiting for the mini set, because apparently, according to Celestalon, there's going to be more sigil support because there's only two in the game. But yeah, Vengeance next turn, you have to trigger 200 sigils, and there's only two in the game right now. So I played a sigil spell Demon Hunter list. This is a wild deck, and I basically just try to generate as much spells as possible, as many sigils, and this just took a long time. There's no great way to do this. It will take a long time. Maybe you want to try an educated Elec and shuffle more into your deck. I didn't bother with that. I just tried to get, you know, with a Vulpira Scoundrel or Scorpid, just trying to get more sigils, and it's just a pain, but you'll eventually get it done. It's just a real frustration. Next, we have the Druid achievements, and the first one is do it for the vines. Cast 5 Druid nature spells in a single turn 25 times. I just played like a Miracle Druid in wild with Auctioneer. I played Yogg just for the funds, but you basically just play Yogg or Auctioneer and just cycle through your deck with like Bio Projects, Innervates, Lightning Blooms, play it, nature spells, and just do this 25 different times. It'll take a multiple amount of games. I wish Jade Idol was a nature spell, but it's not. And yeah, it's deck's fun. You get to Yogg, and overall, you'll just get it done eventually. It's just kind of a pain. Next, we have the Final Frontier. Play 5 cards in a single turn that naturally cost 8 or more. I did with Wild Malagos Druid, especially like Celestial Alignment. You have Kuhn. Just cheat out a bunch of stuff that normally costs 8. You'll get there. But yeah, Celestial Alignment can get this done. You could also just do like an old Aviana Kuhn combo with a bunch of big stuff. That'll also work if you want to do that. And last, we have buy one, get one free of taunt. This one was awful. I highly recommend just not bothering with this. It's painful. This card's garbage. But yeah, if you just Plague Maw the Rotting to resummon taunts with that don't have taunt, I use this taunt druid list. I gave everything rush with like brooms, try to trade them in. You could also try out like Germination, copy up your Plagma as well. I didn't think find that very effective, but you can give that a go. Overall, there's not a really great way of doing this, and it's just going to take a long time. Next, we have the Hunter achievements. We have Pack Attack, Summon 6, Swift Hyenas in a single turn. I just use this Hyena Hunter, like Spell Heavy Hyena Hunter. I got it done eventually, and you can resummon. These are little hyenas. You can resummon them with that 2-mana spell that resummons beasts that have died this game. That helped a lot. I think Revenge of the Wild. It's really quite easy, especially if you have that spell. But even then, just play this with a bunch of cheap spells, trade stuff in. Not too difficult one to get done. We have Like Raptor, Like Sun. This is Trigger the Frenzy on a 5th generation Sun Scale Raptor. This one was a pain, but I queued into a Pirate Warrior that just didn't concede, and I just kept trading stuff in. You can Dire Frenzy stuff. I use Master's Call to kind of draw them out. Worked out all right. Not the most difficult one, but you kind of need to find a willing combatant, give stuff rush, or I use a lot of different proccing stuff. You can see I have a lot of damage activators on my own stuff to proc my raptors, and yeah, you have to play all the way up to the 5th one and then proc it. It's quite the ordeal, but it is doable. And then lastly, I have Who Let the Dogs Out? Summon 75 beasts with Tavish Stormpike. So this one is just a gradual one. You'll eventually get it done with Tavish. But I built this deck from basically 0 mana to 5 mana. Every single beast has either rush or charge, so that if I have Tavish, I can just play stuff out and then trade in and eventually get some stuff down. The idea is to get Tundra Rhino, and then you can just go 4-3-2-1, and then you get your 0 out, and then you're pretty much done, and you do it again. But you can also Dire Frenzy. Say you drew all your 3s, you can Dire Frenzy your 3 to reconnect that chain. So this one just takes some time, and it's actually pretty fun, because Tavish Stormpike's really cool. The deck itself just doesn't really win, but overall, it'll accomplish the goal. Next, we have the Mage achievements with Shatter Combo, destroy 50 frozen minions. I just played APM Mage. You could play like Spell Mage, whatever. You're gonna get this done with just whatever, Ray of Frost or any free spell, Blizzards if you want to go in wild. It's just, this one's pretty simple, not too much to it. We have It's Not Spamming Its Art, deal 300 damage with your Hero Powers Mage. I just got this done in Arena, like just naturally, because your Hero Power. You likely, if you play a decent amount of Mage, you already have this one done, because there's no real specific setup, but I'll highlight here a Hero Power Mage that'll accelerate the process a little bit, but overall, literally just Hero Powers Mage. That's all you really have to do. And then we have Baron's Bubbler. Refresh 8 mana crystals with Refreshing Spring Water in a single turn. Just play Spell Mage, you'll get it done. Like, you know, just play Spring Water twice, it's over, as long as you're running all spells. And Spell Mage is a really good deck right now, at least as of recording this, before any possible nerfs happen. So yeah, a pretty simple one there. Next, we have the Paladin achievements, and the first one we have here is Wear Your Sunday Best. Buff 600 minions with Invigorating Sermon. This one's just annoying. You just have to complete it. I played Prince Malgazar to give my deck more minions to buff, so that was kind of cool. But yeah, just play Sermon a bunch, buff minions. That's all you do. There's really not much more to it than that. We have Spell Slinging Savior. Cast 5 Holy Paladin spells in a single turn 15 times. I played a Wild Libram Paladin. You can do a standard Libram Paladin. Whatever you want to do, just basically get to Liadrin, get a bunch of spells back in your hand, and keep respamming them over and over 15 times. You'll get it done. Doesn't have to be one game. Just overall, again, not too difficult. And then last, we have Just Between You and Me. Trigger 5 Paladin secrets in one turn. So this one is really good to do in wild, because you have Mysterious Challenger can pull out all the secrets at once, which requires your opponent to then usually proc them all in one turn. Whereas if you're using like sword, the weapon, right, it's getting one secret at a time, which is going to get procced one at a time most likely. So really recommend Mysterious Challenger for this one. Get them all procced in one go. This only took me a couple games, wasn't too bad at all. Next, we have the Priest achievements with 2 health bars. Restore 40 health to heroes in one game as priest. This is both heroes, so you have like the 0-mana spell that can work really well. I just played Reno Priest. I healed up with Reno. I seanced Reno, healed some more with Reno. GG was done. You can play other healing combinations or whatever, but Reno Jackson's a pretty good healing card. Next, I have Why Can't I Hold All These Cards? Start 50 turns with a handful and as priest. I played this abomination, Big Caravan Priest, because the caravans added cards to my hand, as well as help for the caravan achievement, which is really annoying, which we'll talk about later. And yeah, I got it done. Pretty much any priest deck that just generates a lot of cards will get this done. You can play the new Malagos, which will fill your hand with spells, and then just pass turns, just play a card a turn. That'll also help out. This one's not too bad. It'll just take some time. And lastly, we have Blood Donation. Attack and kill the drain minion with Serena Blood Feather 5 times. So you have to drain a minion with Serena, then kill it. I just used brooms, gave it rush, traded immediately, and then you can just raise dead both of them right away and do it over and over. I did this in one game. I generated a random raise dead from a Shadow Visions, and I literally did it in one game. This one's not too bad. Just run only Serena Bloodfeather and Broom and Insight. You'll drop pretty consistently and you'll get this one done in no time. Next, we have the Rogue achievements, starting off with Identity Theft is Not a Joke, Yoink all 10 hero powers. I played this in like a high cycle Kingsbane Rogue in Wild and just kept track of the hero powers I discovered. Important to note, you do need to get the Rogue hero power. So first you have to yoink into any other hero power, right? Like Warrior, Demon Hunter, whatever. And then you have to yoink again while it's up, and then you might be offered the Rogue hero power. So just keep doing it, just keep yoinking, you'll eventually get it, and just keep track of which ones you have. It'll also show your progress, the achievement thing, and you'll have a good idea of what you need to do. Then we have Just Don't Touch the Blade, coat a Swine Tusk Shank with 4 different poisons. I played a very similar weapon rogue style, Kingsbane rogue style in Wild, and just instead of Kingsbane, I put in, you know, the shank and just buffed it up. All you gotta do is buff it up with 4 different poisons. Not too difficult, you'll get it done. And then we have Magnets. How do they work? Play 12 cards in a single turn as Rogue. I recommend you just play Rogue, because you'll probably do this in Rogue, but I played like this Wild Field Contact Rogue that was literally just all cheap cards and just played them in like on with like 5 mana, and it was like ridiculously easy. This one's it's Rogue, it's super easy. Next we have Shaman, with the first one being My Dear Watson, play an elemental 5 turns in a row. I just played this elemental Shaman deck. It only has elementals, so you're gonna play 5 in a row, pretty easy. Probably not gonna win, but you'll play 5 elementals in a row. Then we have Extra Organic, deal 150 extra damage with nature spells. I'm highlighting here a spell damage Shaman. It works pretty well, except do not be baited into thinking Morgue Artificer will count, because it doesn't, which is really annoying. So yeah, just get your spell damage stuff. It counts on your own minions. Just nuke the board. You can nuke your own, like play the Mad Summoning Imp card and nuke your own imps. That works too. Like just blow up the board a bunch. You'll get there. AoE is your best bet. And last, we have Murloc Down. Destroy 50 enemies with Murlocs as Shaman. Murloc Shaman's a good deck in Wild. It runs all Murlocs. Just play this list, kill things with Murlocs, and you'll get it done. Not too much, not really anything crazy there. I got this one done in Arena, like because you get Murlocs in Arena a lot, so I got it done there. Next, we have the Warlock achievements with Discard Inferno. Destroy 3 legendary cards with a single Altar of Fire. I just put in a deck of 28 legendaries and 2 Altar of Fires and Mulligan for Altar of Fire. Play it and you're done. Unless you hit the other Altar of Fire with your Altar of Fire, then you gotta try it again. But you're probably not gonna win. But again, you just have to burn legendaries. And it could be your opponents too, but I just wanted to guarantee it. It took one game, really easy peasy. Then we have What's Better Than 2 Imps? Summon 250 Imps. I built like a Wild Galakrond Imp Warlock, as every invoke summons imps, and just put a bunch of imp cards in there, and I actually went positive with this deck. That was actually kind of funny. And yeah, just summon imps, you'll get it done eventually, and the Galakrond makes it pretty easy to accomplish. And then we have Shadow of a Shadow Cast, 80 zero cost Warlock shadow spells. I played Dark Lair Warlock for this because it's a high cycle deck. You got Tamsmin and just, you know, play POs, play your Drain Souls, and eventually it'll get done. You can play it with whatever you want with Tamsmin, make it zero, or just play, just Raise Deads. Raise Deads count on their own. If that's the only one you want to play, just play Raise Dead, it'll count. But overall, that's what I did, and it didn't take too long. And for the last class, we have Warrior, with I'll take more than that, have 100 friendly minions survive damage on your turn as Warrior. I actually completed this in Classic with Control Warrior, but I'll just highlight a Dead Man's Hand Warrior here, because you want to do a lot of risky skipper turns, so you'll have a lot of damage stuff, so you could give that one a go. That'll work out pretty well. Next is Gym Buddies. This one I did in Arena just by accident, but use Bulk Up to create a fourth copy of the same minion in your hand. I'll highlight a Wild Taunt Warrior with Bulk Up in it. Just play it until you get 4 copies. You run your 2 Bulk Ups. If you want, you can, you know, run Spell Generation to get more, but overall, not too difficult. Just manipulate it so that you're going to copy the same taunt multiple times. And lastly, we have Hardcore Rancor. Gain 14 armor with a single Rancor. So you can just play Control Rancor Warrior. And I'm highlighting, I just put in here Mad Summoner, which fills the entire board. So you could just play Mad Summoner, Rancor, and you're definitely going to get it done. You can, you know, probably get it done just with a regular Rancor deck, but this way you don't even have to rely on your opponent to summon minions. You'll accomplish it. And lastly, we have the neutral achievements, starting off with Sting Operation. Destroy 25 minions with Venomous Scorpid. Got this done in Arena, but you can play this like with Control Priest. While you raise dead them, you can Hysteria minions into it. It'll work. It's a gradual one. And Control Priest is really good, so you might have fun with that. We have Frenzy Friends, trigger 100 Frenzy effects. Again, this is just a time progression one. I highlight here a Control Frenzy Warrior. You could play like just Miracle Rogue with like Octobot, that'll count. Again, I just got this done in Arena over time, but you can accelerate it with that deck. We have Hog Wild, another achievement I got done in Arena. Summon 50 Hogs with Hog Rancher. I'll highlight here a Rush Warrior where I put Hog Rancher in it. What do you know? It'll work. It's fine. We have Spawn Shop. Summon 50 Demon Spawn with Burning Blade Acolyte. I just played Big Priest with Demon Spawns and just kept resurrecting Demon Spawns because it works. And it worked pretty well. And, you know, again, you can do it with whatever deck you want, but Big Priest is a pretty good way to do it because you keep bringing them back. Of Life is a Highway, start 100 turns of the Caravan. So this one's really annoying. Caravans really suck. The big Caravan Priest list I showed you earlier did a really good job, and they stack. Say you have three Caravans live at the beginning of your turn because you res a bunch with a Spellstone. They couldn't remove it. That counts three times towards the progress. So I actually got this done relatively quickly once I started playing it in the big Priest list. But again, you can just play Caravan like an aggro Paladin list, like even Paladin with a Call to Arms. That's one way because you're very aggressive. It can be hard for them to deal with. But I just recommend this. It worked out very well for me. Next, we have Maximum Security, play 50 Watch Posts. They're nerfed now, so they suck a lot more. But I'll just highlight here a Watch Post Paladin in Wild with a Call to Arms. It just runs all of them. It's okay. You'll get it done. But again, you can just literally just throw Watch Posts into any deck. Just play them 50 times. You'll get the achievement done, and you'll get some points. We have signature moves, and this one was a pain. Cast 100 rank 3 spells. So rank 3 spell only gets there when you get to 10 mana. So you can play like a hyper ramp druid, but I did infinite Elise druid, where I would literally go infinite spamming rank 3 spells over and over just to get this one done because it takes forever. You can only run a couple copies of rank 3 spells. A lot of games in Hearthstone don't get to 10 mana. This one's going to take a long time. Just put rank 3 spells in your deck, get it done, I guess. You could try the infinite Elise thing, but even when I would do my APM turn, I could still only play like 15 in a turn, and then I would die because my deck has no win condition, and it would suck. This one was awful. This one really sucks, and hopefully you'll get it done before the expansion is complete. Next, we have Everyone's In Here, and your turn with 7 Gruntled Patrons. I built a wild Gruntled Patron Warrior. You just need 2 Gruntled Patrons, Whirlwind, Inner Rage, you're done. That's all you gotta do. Just get to that point and you'll have 7 on the board. We have, has anyone seen Mancrick's Wife? Destroy your opponent with Mancrick Consumed by the Hatred. I actually did this in Arena, of all things. I did this in Arena, but I just recommend trying like Tempo Rogue because you can Shadow Step Mancrick a bunch, and eventually one of these games you'll just finish your opponent off with Mancrick's Wife, and that's it. That's all you have to do. It's, there'll be some RNG and luck. You could probably build a specific OTK for this, but overall I think you can just get there by playing Tempo Rogue and just shadow stepping it, getting a bunch of copies of it. Next, we have Top Secret Snoop, probably the most annoying and most difficult achievement on the list. Copy 5 secrets with a single Horde operative. It's important to note, if you have 5 secrets up yourself and you copy 5 and it doesn't like give you new secrets, it still counts. Thankfully, it still counts. So what I did is I built a Cho Secret Paladin Wild. Cho, I played Cho, 5 secrets, played Millhouse to make everything 0 and hope my opponent got the clue. And eventually one of my opponents got the clue, played all the secrets, and I copied them with Horde Operative, and I never have to do this one again. You could also just hope to queue into like a secret rogue or, you know, a secret deck on ladder and just hope for that. But I tried to set it up myself and it eventually worked. It took about 2 hours of trying, and it was a real pain in the butt. So we have Equivalent Exchange, swap a 0 cost minion with a 10 cost minion with Shadowhunter Vol'jin. I just did Mechathune Warlock. You even win the game by swapping your like your Snowflipper Penguin or your Target Dummy, whatever, and getting Mechathune out and Cataclysming. You can do whatever 0 and 10 drop, but Mechathune Warlock was a pretty reliable way of doing it. And we have Build a Rock Workshop, build custom golems using all 12 herbs using Kazakus. Again, I just recommend Tempo Rogue. You can shadow step it and just keep track of whatever herbs you used. It's basically the attributes like draw 2 cards, deal damage, whatever, right? As long as you pick them all 12, you'll eventually get this done. And yeah, you need Kazakus, so again, Play it a bunch, you'll get done. It doesn't take that long. There's only 12 of them. And last, we have Grand Guardian. Summon a 10-cost minion with Primordial Protector. I just recommend playing Druid with, like, Survival of Fittest. I did with, like, Clown Druid in Wild. You can run Ultimate Infestation as well. But, yeah, you just play Primordial. You draw your 10-cost spell. You're done. And that's every achievement. Hopefully, this guide gives you guys a little bit of a boost to try and get some XP on the rewards track. And good luck on your achievement hunting. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Have a great day. And stay salty, my friends.